don't like mad. They're coarse and rough and irritating. And they get everywhere. Not like here. Here everything is soft and smooth.
Don't f***ing touch me.
I killed them. I killed them all. They're dead. Every single one of them. But not just the misfits, but Vitality and Origin too. They're like feeders, and I slaughtered them like feeders. I hate them!
Did you ever hear the tragedy of Faker Dage the Wise?
No.
I thought not. It's not a narrative the casters would tell you. It's an LEC legend. Faker Dage was a dark lord of the mid lane. So wise and so powerful, he could use his W to steal summoner spells, to create winds. He had such a knowledge of the dark side. He could even use his power to prevent teams he cared about from losing.
Is it possible to learn this power?
Not from a caster.
Gilius, I told you it would come to this. Fnatic and G2 are taking over.
You fool. The Shocker Miracle Run cannot continue. Your plot to control the region is over. You have lost.
Now, you will die!
He's a traitor! Stop him!
I have the power to save your run to worlds. You must choose!
Execute order, Noel Fear.
Yeah, Phanios is down, the Tom Kench is down, the show has been stopped.
They're quiet!
Master Gilius, there's too many of them. What are we gonna do?
I have failed you, Gilius. I have failed you. I should have known G2 were plotting to take over. Gilius, Shalka no fear is evil. From my point of view, G2 are evil. Well, then you are lost. It's over, Gilius. I have level 18 smite. You underestimate my power. Don't try it. Ah! You were the garbage one. It was said you would miss playoffs, not join them. Bring balance to the LEC, not leave it in darkness.
I hate G2!
You were last place, Gilius. I loved memeing you.
Welcome to Berlin, Germany, home of the LEC Summer Playoffs. Round 2 has arrived. It is time for a show. The stakes are now higher than ever as Schalke and Mad Lions fight for a spot at Worlds. Now, last week, we expected the rise of the new blood, but what we got was a return of the Kings.
Katie. Yeah, I mean, G2 really stepped up, Fnatic really stepped up. These teams, Fnatic...
When you have the room to be flexible and get to adapt, that's really where you get to see some of the star power of G2 and Fnatic, and we got a great show last week.
Yeah, but for Rogue and Mad, it wasn't great, and especially Rogue, I think, shocked me the most in how they underperformed so much last week and were no match for Fnatic.
Yeah, you saw Rogue throughout the whole sort of summer split. They were so consistent. The team fights were nailed, the macro was nailed, the drafts were nailed, but it just felt like...
Yeah, they can bounce back, but will they? G2 and Fnatic, however, are now in the upper bracket still. Mad Lions and Schalke are battling for the right to challenge Rogue, and also...
It's best of five will decide who locks in that spot at Worlds, and then we will get that race for the LEC title.
That we will, and we also want to hear from the viewers at home, which of the teams in the lower bracket do you think is most likely to make a title run, so to go deep in the playoffs? Spam now in chat, MadSO4 or RGE. For Rogue, Kadro, I'm going to pose that same question to you. Who out of those teams could make a deep run and crawl out of that lower bracket?
Well, I would say Rogue if they can find...
Wrong. And I think that of the three teams in the lower bracket, Mad is the one that can most likely take games off the big two.
Well, we'll check in with the vote in just a second, but just so that we have it out there, is anyone going to challenge Fnatic or G2 in that upper bracket?
I think I need to see this week's games, but I genuinely believe MAD can. I think they can.
Vedius is a MAD believer. I think Rogue. I'm more of a Rogue believer if they can find their form. Otherwise, Schalke is going to come to that semifinals and they're probably going to make fun of Fnatic.
Make fun of Fnatic. People at home, 80% voting for Schalke. I mean, yeah, the hype train, there's just nothing to be done about it. We did see a lot of great performances last week, also individually. Vedius, who were your standout players in that first round of playoffs?
Well, Shocks, I had three, and that means I need to go over to the three wall.
A little taste of what is to come tomorrow. Two of the most winningest organizations in Europe take each other on again. But the record is against them for Fnatic. They are 0-7 versus G2 in 2020. That's not how we want to start that best of five.
Yeah, they definitely must have some kind of mental edge or like a mental buff versus Fnatic in the end. I think G2 has just shown that time and time again, they're just the better team. Mm-hmm.
And I think that while Fnatic look great, the problem they always have with G2 is that it comes out of nowhere. And it feels like that G2 just always seem to have Fnatic's number.
Yeah, that's true. Maybe a bit of a mental breakdown there from the side of the Fnatic players, but they have to start fresh. You brought it up. You said that final, it was so much in G2's favor in spring. And they even said that kind of caught us off guard.
Yep.
And we suffered from that. But now the playoff buff is activated for both Fnatic and for G2, but will it be enough?
I am hoping so.
Yeah.
I can't be confident
games,
right now. Yeah, I think that Fnatic look great, and if they can bring out the performance that they did against Rogue, then I have high optimism this is going to be a great series.
That's tomorrow, but today and tonight, Schalke and Mad Lions take to the Rift in a series with everything on the line. Parzi has a dream, but Schalke 04 is living the dream of the miracle run. And we just pulled up the standings at the end of week four to show you what has transpired since then and how impressive the run from Schalke has been.
So as you can see, it was pretty much done and dusted.
Yeah, exactly. I love that you brought that up, because I think the hype is big. We also saw it with 80% of the people voting for it, and they're just riding that wave. And honestly, they went from a miracle run to this might be one of the best teams in the league. We don't want to go too far, but until they stop winning, what can you really say about the squad?
I mean, that's the thing. It's difficult to criticize them. Then whatever it is that they're doing, no team seems to be able to find an answer for it. They out. Where were you when Schalke was? I was here. I got to watch. And so I think I'm really excited to see if that reality does come.
And I think what you said is the most important point. No one's been able to find an answer yet. It's been like 4 or 5 weeks, 10 games in a row, and no one's found an answer, not even Mad Lions.
No, they haven't. But now let's look at their opponents and Mad Lions, because with this whole hype around
impressive, and if they can lock in that world spot, I think that just kind of that's going to round out what has already been a fantastic gift for Mad
Lions. But you've said it all. They could also not get it, and that would be such a heartbreaker. But I think you have to look in the mirror when you're the Schalke, the Mad Lions players. I mean, both of them, but especially Mad when it comes to Worlds, because they had so many chances to directly take their fate into their own hands.
Yep.
The game versus Rogue, the game versus Schalke on the last day. So I think the pressure must be enormous, and the heartbreak would be enormous if they can't make it. All on the line for Matt today. So let's see what their coach had to say before today's series. Thank you very much. Always lovely to hear from Mac. And I said back-to-back coach of the split, but now it is for all the marbles. Laura also asked about last week. And let's pull up the gold graph of how hard Schalke dominated SK. Now, I do think he made a fantastic point there, Cadrel, just about, yeah, the fact that if this happens as the enemy team, you don't have that much to scout because you don't have a lot of material.
Yeah, I think if you look at the Mad G2 series,
what are the team right now with?
I mean, you said it. You used them in the same sentence. Get your Twitter, your tweets ready, rather. But let's talk a bit more about Schalke and how they get that advantage and how they are able to accelerate. What do they go for in terms of compositions?
So I really
over and over just with slightly different pieces.
And a good point by Mac, but they could. They've just have not been really tested.
I mean, that's
in the last
true, right? They could
weeks.
Actually have more lined up.
We don't know. And I think this is why the series will be so interesting, because we will see more from both sides. And I think when we talk about the Mad Lions and our compositions, we also have to highlight flexibility, but in a completely different manner.
Yeah, I really like Matt Page from Fnatic's book.
Mm-hmm. And Shadow versus Gilius. What a hype matchup in and of itself. As a small quick update, we have been informed by league management that we are currently experiencing an issue with getting players into the lobby, and we will be a bit delayed getting into our first game. We will pass on updates as we get them. We do have content for you. You know, we get paid to talk, so I hope we can do it. We're also going to see what the viewers think right now. Who will win this series, Mad or SO4? spam in chat. We're going to get to predictions already. Hopefully, then we can get into game, but we'll see. So you have some time for this. Vettius, who are you going for?
So I am predicting Mad Lions.
Mac can...
Juggling skills.
What's that called in English? Juggling. I didn't know. Jongleren in Dutch. What I want to get at, as we still have a little bit of time...
Wait, that's...
He dropped on.
That was pretty good. What I kind of wanted to touch on as well... Oh, man, when we get into territory where we haven't prepared, I really need to, like, keep these all in check, because
Please, otherwise they'll go off the rails.
What I wanted to talk about was just the amount of stress and kind of pressure, and I think Schalke has really shown that it is not affecting them. They have also said that continuously throughout the interviews in the last couple of weeks on a 10-game winning streak. You've talked about the fact that it's very hard to keep that going, but they seem to be unaffected entirely. The Mad Lions on the other side, even though there's a fantastic system in place, it must be in the back of their heads. We let it slip through our fingers a couple of times, and now we're here, and we got to play Schalke in a best of five. How do you think that will affect them?
Well, I think that's five starts to swing.
Super interesting. I heard that we may still have 10 minutes before we get into that first game, so we're going to keep you entertained. We also have an interview for you, because earlier we spoke to Neon about what it was like playing on the LEC stage a while ago, I guess. Let's check in with him.
Okay, so the journey was very difficult, or like for me personally, I have always kind of been in LEC and I've always been hovering. I was always subbing into the last place teams, you know? And I was always like the guy who kind of subbed in, but didn't make a difference, you know, in the last places. So this year I thought that it was just going to be like all over the same, you know. But I realized that if this is going to be me for the rest of my career, then I'm not going to be seen in LEC like again, you know. So I honestly went all in on everything. Like every single one of us went all in and did their absolute best, whether it comes to like preparation, putting in additional time in solo queue, or just making sure the practice in scrims stays good and the atmosphere is good. Especially for me, this is huge because I finally get to show that I can compete and I am on the LEC level. And there is no one who like outshines me, that it's finally a time to start showing that, especially to my family and friends, that like all this time it didn't go to waste, that putting school, friends and family aside was actually for something, you know, and that that I can play on the highest level.
Wow, lovely to hear from Neon. This is kind of a side of him we haven't seen yet or heard from, I would say. And it's something, you know, you can't think about too much, you know, even as casters and when you're doing the show, about how kind of this is such a big sacrifice for every one of these players. And they have so much they're fighting against that is not necessarily out in the open, right? And especially for Neon, he's right. I mean, even a couple of weeks back when they were 1-8, it was like the NX came in and this and that, and it wasn't sure who would get a shot and if they would even stay there. But somehow he made it work, and that's really good for him and for Schalke.
I mean, he was...
We will get to K-Drill in a second. Just a small update. We have received an update from League Management. They have resolved the issue. Players are getting into Champion Select right now, and we'll get it on your screen in about 8 minutes. So let's immediately jump right onto that. I also kind of want to talk about what we've seen from him. You said like the only Ashe that was winning in EU actually in week 8. Also that they default to Senna a lot. What can you say about Neon's style and the role he's played for the team and how you think it could get exploited or they can show us different things in this best of five?
I feel like Neon was just the perfect fit.
What they can do on the international
stage. Great point. I think within them also lies the hunger because they know what their predecessors have done with a third seed or a fourth seed.
Yeah?
And they say, we can do this as well. Give us a chance. Well, you have to step up and take it. It all comes down to this for Schalke and Mad. Who will be EU's final team at Worlds 2020? Let's find out. Welcome back, everyone, to the LEC Summer Playoffs. Mad Lions, they bounced back with a crucial win, and the first time in 12 games, Schalke's Nexus was destroyed. We have a series on our hands, and if you don't believe me, we do. I could use a close-up right now. Nobody's going to read this from there. That's all right. Anyway, let's talk about picks and bans. As we ended the last segment, you guys said, I do not want to see a first pick Akali out of the Mad Lions. They still went for it, but which adaptations did we see that made this work, Cadrel?
Well, I think the Akali first pick in the last game, it did have some impact. I think the main struggle they had was the jungle support and the AD carry. I like that they switched it up. They went for the Lee Sin, Ashe, Nautilus. Way more playmaking, way more engage, way more utility in the game.
Yeah, I agree with Cadrel. I think he hit all the main points. And I think that, for me, one of the biggest things was we got to see what happens when Schalke doesn't save from Shadow.
Absolutely. So Shadow picks this Lee Sin, and you know this is in part because it's good for the comp, but also this is his pick, and he knows what to do on it. And I think this top lane play was so crucial because in my mind, if that goes the other way, you're in a whole different space of mind as Shadow.
Yeah, they
bounce back tremendously. Vettius, you also wanted to take an in-depth look and that top lane fight in 22 minutes, which really sealed the deal for Matt.
So people thought that I only needed that to do the Drory tools, but I brought my little computer thing with me. I name him Al. Anyway, so this top lane play, what Cadrel and I wanted to draw attention to was Humanoid. Now, we're going to slow this one down as I start this one off, right? So you're going to keep an eye on Humanoid and how he's sidestepping beautifully absolutely everything. So Cadrel, why don't you run us through this as we're going to play this one out?
Yeah, so he actually uses Inns up, the TP comes in, and that eventually leads to Neon's death.
Yeah, and I think a wonderful game out of the Mad Lions. And individually, you know, when you're a Humanoid, you get that Akali again, and now you absolutely make it work. You're winning fights when not even all your carries are there, and this is exactly what they needed to bounce back. They were on blue side. Now Schalke is on blue side, of course, because that's what they picked after losing that game. Now, talk to me, Vettius, about the mental game. You already said, well, Matt, hey, bounce back, fantastic. Schalke has seen that defeat screen for the first time now in 12 games. How is that going to affect
them? Well, this is the thing, right? I think that one of the big advantages the Schalke have had is that they've been on this constant win streak, but now they've suddenly been stopped in their tracks. They're the ones that have to adapt. They have to find a way of deadlines.
Yeah, I mean, Schalke, first defeat in 5 weeks. I don't think it's going to hurt them too much. We'll see if they have adaptability here. Can they adapt in the draft? Can they adapt to a loss?
Yep, they do. We'll see what happens. It was a big change in momentum for the Mad Lions, who are looking to get to match point after this. Welcome everyone to the LEC post-game lobby. I'm Shox. I'm joined here by Cadrel and by Karzy. Karzy, man, congratulations on an incredible year with the Mad Lions, and now finally your hands on that world spot. What were your first reactions when you killed that last Nexus and you made worlds?
I'm happy that my team carried me.
So what you mean is you're not too happy with your own performance, which is why you weren't as happy in the win moment. But Karzy, that's why you're a team, right? You need to pick up after each other, and sometimes someone else carries.
Yeah, well, that's true. Shadow had excellent.
Three is on more comfortable picks. Do you think that was the set pick more reactionary, or was it something you planned for?
Well, the set pick was.
Tell me about kind of how you mentally were in the team after that first loss, because we were kind of afraid that if that first game got lost by you guys, that you might lose the plot completely. But it was the opposite. You actually recovered so well and then took three in a row. What could you say was the atmosphere after that first game, and what was said?
After the first game, I don't think it wasn't anything hard.
Cadrel, you did have the Schalke as the win. You were on the hype train. So what is your expert read on the series?
I just think the Akali prior from Mad Lions was really good. Schalke always responded with these control mage.
Even though you said you were inting a little bit, did you also feel like the key was in that bot lane and getting the right priority in terms of Ashe and Senna?
I think, and played.
Yeah, it did look like it. We're going to come back to you in just a second, Karzy, and talk about Worlds and, of course, the rest of playoffs. But we do also have an interview with Gilius from Schalke, so let's listen to that.
Thank you, Shox, and thank you, Gilius, for joining me actually after this series. It's an honor to be talking to you again.
All good. Done being said.
Yeah, they were talking about the series, so let's talk about this first. Back to you, Shox.
Thank you very much, very graceful of Gilius, and also just humble in defeat, saying Mad were the better team today, and there's just nothing more about that. Karzy, is there anything you want to say about your opponents, about Schalke, who in the end had a fantastic run, but you were just a better team today?
And I have a great respect for them, but That's it.
You wanted to be cheeky, I saw it. But yeah, that's the truth. They had a fantastic run. I will be looking for it with what they can do later. But now let's talk about the Mad Lions. You are locked for Worlds 2020, but you are also face Rogue on Sunday. The brackets so far, and after what you saw from Mad today, what do you think about their hopes of an LEC final and or championship?
I think it all comes down to Rogue, to be honest. I think they were
split and people just prepared for them now.
Oh my gosh, these answers.
It's simple.
I've been very straight fire so far. Talk to me about a possible G2 rematch. How much do you think you've grown since spring that gives you the confidence that you could beat them this time?
I have a
question maybe about you guys. Worlds is so exciting and you get to go and play versus the best teams and the best players in the world. Are there any specific teams, I know like 10 or so have qualified, and even if they haven't yet, you'd really like to play against?
NTSM for the memes.
For the memes, indeed. Now, let's get a little preview of tomorrow. Of course, it'll be G2 versus Fnatic for a spot in the final. Both teams got a great start to the summer playoffs. Let me get your predictions. Kadril, do you want to start? What do you think about tomorrow?
Well, Fnatic's shown that they can play one style in the best of five against Rogue. I think G2's going to look at that best of five and see the style.
To a rematch versus G2, so I guess you think G2 is going to win. Why do you think they're better than Fnatic right now?
I think that they are just individually better. They also have better read at the meta, on the meta.
Okay. Before we sign off, is there anything you want to say to the Mad Lions faithful? You've put them through the ringer the last couple of weeks because you're number one, then you didn't lock Worlds, and they got so scared, and then you had to play Schalke in a best of five. What do you want to say to all the Mad Lions fans who are happy that you finally made it to Worlds?
They're very happy.
I love it. All right. You want to take a selfie, Karzy?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you're allowed to say no, but that would be kind of embarrassing, I guess. Here we go.
I need to also, I need to come closer, right?
Let's see. Closer to back. Oh, that's actually very close. I have a super close. Can you go a bit further back, actually? Because we have your face in it. Boom. All right. Okay. To your right. Can you go to your right? This is the hardest one yet.
Should I move? Wait.
No, back to your left.
To my left?
Wait, I'm just gonna try an angle. No.
Keep dodging him.
The other side. Yes, there. Oh my god, this is this dodging. What else? Dodge runes? Okay, we got it. Okay, that was the hardest one to pull off, but I don't know what left and right is, apparently. Thank you so much, Karzy. Congratulations. Can't wait to see you in the rest of playoffs and at Worlds. That was all from us here in Berlin. Be sure to check out the LCS Academy Finals between Cloud9 and TSM. We'll be back tomorrow for Fnatic versus G2. See you then.
Bye-bye.
'Cause Dreams has already used the Devour. They can't save anyone else. Odawame on the backside looking straight for Kaiser, or Karzy rather. Gonna get run down, and the rest of the team now retreating. Schalke holding on, but their biggest enemy now is the Baron in the pit. They are gonna be able to finish it. That is disaster for Mad Lion. What they're looking for, but Humanoid still manages to make it out. He goes golden, he cancels out the ultimate. Kaiser gonna step forward to try to body block. Humanoid is still alive now. Right now, Ilias now moving in. He's kept the Dream alive. The rest of the team now needs to back off, though, because it's Arome on the backside. Schalke just gonna get picked to pieces. In comes the Ash. Gilius trying to finish the kill desperately, but Shadow, he's just prancing around.
Oh.
He can't be stopped. The double kill coming through.
This is it. It's over.
Kill. Mad Lions will bring us to match point onto Kaiser. That's not what he needs. That's it. That's the double kill. The GG hard to come out. Mad Lions are here. They've proven themselves to Europe, and now they can prove themselves to the world. They're gonna try and buy a bit more space, but he cannot connect. Now the rest of the team now coming in. Yankos, though, he's already used the grid. He's gonna be very squishy, but they cannot quite kill him because an unbreakable comes in at the perfect time.